Unsa ba ang mas nindot na negosyo? Is it network marketing or traditional business? Now, the good thing about this, guys, kaya ako personally, na-experience ako ang network marketing when I was 16 years old. And as of now, naamidwa ka book negosyo, which is into traditional business as well, / online business. Personally, I find these two businesses to be great. It really depends kung saan mas bagay sa imo. Lahi-lahi ni siya og mga considerations o mga sistema na kailangan nimo bantayan or at least man lang makabalo ka before you start engaging in either of these two businesses. So the first one is capitalization, no? Ang kwarta na atong ipagawas in order for us to start a business. Ako ang nabantayan sa network marketing, mo ni siya ang mga nasa mga 15,000 pesos per account, sagad na siya. Depende po na siya sa package imong kwaon, depende po na siya sa katong negosyo or katong kumpanya na imong apilan. So by the way, if you don't know what network marketing is, ang iyang concept is mahimo kang isa ka distributor sa isa ka negosyo na kay products madawat at a discounted price na pwede mo siya ibaligya para nakay ganansya. You can also invite people to join that specific network marketing company para naapod they too will become business people. At the same time, you will earn commissions out of it. Now, sa traditional business naman, naanin siya yung mga dako-dako na mga capitalization. Mutanay mo na sa mga 20,000, 50,000, swerte na kay kakuna, kay nana na traditional business na ma-start ni mo at that amount. Mas dako ang capitalization tungod kay mag-arkila siguro ka. At the same time, you're going to pay for those imuha mga employees, imuhang inventory, and imuha mga operating costs. No, sama sa utilities, electricity, and whatsoever in order for your business to survive. Sa ato pa, in terms of money, mas dako jud kag ipagawas sa traditional business compared mo sa network marketing business. Ang ikaduha naman po is ang sistema. Now, when it comes to the network marketing business, since nag-join ka sa ilahang business, ang nahulog ana is that naana kay sistema na igo lang nimo sa sundon. Naana sila yung mga compensation plan. Pag once na kay taon ma-invite, pag once join siya sa katong business, then mapadulong sa left, then nasa right, then once mag-pairing na siya, nakay madawat na commission, mauni siya ang standard retail price sa kanina product. So pag once ibaligyan nimo siya sa market, dapat maudyo na siya ang pricing, and so on and so forth. Sa to pa, there is a system in place na igo na lang nimo siya sundun. Sa traditional negosyo mango, just like what I keep on mentioning, pag once na kay negosyo, at least man lang, imong i-set up ang imong operations, marketing, sales, and finance. Maunto siya ang four essential parts of any business. It's hard to start a traditional business without a system. Ang ikatulo naman po is ang tao. Sa network marketing, pag once na akay ma-invite, then mo join sila, it becomes, or he or she becomes your downline. Sila na bahala kung saan nila pag-discarte sa negosyo as long as namusunod nilang sistema and dili po sila mo-siwil sa patakaran sa negosyo. Dili po ni mo sila swildado. Unlike mangod sa traditional business, swildado ni mo sila. That means, kung unsa ang imong gipangdikta sila ha, as long as wala po to sa inyong kontrata, no, sa job description sa katong empleyado, kailangan nila to tumanong tungod kay they are being paid by you as the employer. Pero sa network marketing, dili ka ingon na makamandar-mandar tungod kay dili manani mo sila empleyado. They are part of your team. You can inspire them, you can lead them, no, to take action on some things, but you cannot make them to do something. That's a different story. Tungod kay sa traditional business, ikaw ang employer, pag-abot sa network marketing, ikaw ang leader. Question of the day, unsa ba ang mas nindot na klaseng negosyo? Do you find network marketing to be a better option or traditional business? Or maybe both? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section.